In my last video about the Casey Neistat court, I got a lot of complaints that I talked really fast and folks couldn't understand me. This brought me back to my childhood when teachers would get on my case for the very same thing, and I was called Speedy Gonzales by more than a couple of grammar school and high school teachers. I just had a lot of things to say and I wanted to get them out quickly, but I got tripped up over words easily and ended up with a slight stutter, which made me really try to slow down. And it worked, kinda. I still get complaints from Nick Abruzzi regularly though. Anywho, I picked up a teleprompter and it's been a game changer for me, and I've been using it pretty regularly. See my review of it on my channel. It really helped eliminate my on-screen stutter, and without realizing it, I started talking really fast on camera again, and thus my problems with the last video. Someone even mentioned I give the MicroMachines guy from the 80s commercials a run for his money, and it gave me an idea to test that comparison out. So I dug up his appearance on Robot Chicken a few years ago and went to town. I chose this one instead of his actual commercials because the transcription of what he said was immediately available. I hope you enjoy it.
MicroMachines man here to tell you about the genuine original marvelous majestic MicroMachines street fabric colossal collection. Make these cars zoom in, vroom, veer and steer, jump and foam, flip and fly. MicroMachines man used to own a 1965 Mustang convertible, but his wiggly witch divine wife took it in and everything he owned to shock the existence of divorce fiend that left yours truly domestically devoid of testicles, not a nothing but an endless scrumpy scrum swing between his legs like a portentous pendulum, tick-tock ticking away the fleeting remains of yesterday's youth, vim and vigor. Yes, the seek out from the black hole of despair married MicroMachines man, not for any everlasting promise of eternal tongue tickling, but for an amorphous amour that only a sick sad succubus could inflict on a rapidly boiling butthead with poor potential products. I'll never see my kids again. Tonight's Saturday nights when a ridge ramming through rifle and rattle gets frenetically flayed and red matter goes splitter splattered in a big blanket of dim dark darkness gives cold comfort to a broken bitter bastard. One more pointless product you can't take with you to the grave. By Galoob.
Well, I actually clocked in his dialogue at 39 seconds. While he clocked in at 50 seconds, he was much more polished than I could ever be. But I think, with practice, I'd give him a good challenge. From initial concept of doing this to completing film, it took me less than an hour. Imagine if I practiced. Here's his clip to compare it to.
A colossal collection. Make these cars zoom and vroom, veer and steer, jump and bump, flip and fly. MicroMachines man used to own the 1965 Mustang convertible, but his wickedly butchified wife took it and everything he owned in a shockingly sadistic divorce proceeding that left yours truly emasculated, devoid of testicles, not a nothing but an endless empty squirt of swinging between his legs, like a portentous pendulum tick-tock ticking away the fleeting remains of yesterday's youth, vim and vigor. Yes, the sea cap of the black hole of despair married MicroMachines man, not for the everlasting promise of eternal punch, but for an amorphous amour, only a sick sad succubus could affectionately inflict on a rapidly balding butthead with poor potential prospects. I'll never see my kids again. Tonight's the night of nights when a widget Remington rifle barrel gets frenetically filleted and brain matter goes splitter splatter in the big blanket of dim dark darkness gives cold comfort to a broken bitter bastard. The more pointless product you can't take with you to the grave. Bye-galoo.
Thanks, guys. And don't forget to click like, subscribe, and check out the rest of my channel. There's a lot of interesting stuff in there. Take care.